We have to look first and foremost to people that live in Canada, are Canadians, residents in Canada. They're our first priority.
I mean, how do you make sure a home is vacant anyway?
Well, if the garbage doesn't go out, there's one situation. If there's no cars parked on the driveway, there's another situation. But again, somebody might be a snowbird and they're going back and forth to down south. You can't really make sure of that.
All right. City Councilor Jim Karagiannis, we appreciate your time.
Thank you for having me.
All right. Well, a new research facility has been announced downtown today that will be dedicated to developing artificial intelligence. We're live at CB24's Courtney Heels at the Mars Discovery District, where the Vector Institute will be located. Hey, Courtney, looking like the Great Gazoo or somebody from Deadmau5. Take your pick.
It is a bit different, right? But this is an example of artificial intelligence, Nathan. And the idea here is that this is a demo that people can take in here at the Vector Institute. This is a technology that we are going to see develop, something we know the federal and provincial government will continue to invest in here. So right now, what I can see is an infrared outlook of my cameraman, Tristan. I'm going to bring in Ben now. So tell me a little bit about this helmet, because this is something we could see in the markets in the years to come.
Yeah, so what you're wearing right now is a smart helmet that gives you almost superhuman powers. You can see things that you were not able to see before, and it connects you to the enterprise AI system. Yeah. And it will empower the workforce of the future, the industrial worker, to perform their work faster and more productive and safer. So it will be very exciting in the future. Industrial workers will wear helmets like that. Mm-hmm. It's a safety helmet, smart glass, and augmented reality with AI all in one.
Yeah, and safety is key there. So it's almost like everything that I would need as an employee is right in front of me on the helmet here. Now, Frank's going to come in. Tell us about the Vector Institute, what this means for your company here, and this technology that we know is the future.
So we're very excited to be part of the Vector Institute launch. Accenture is sponsoring the event here with the Institute with $5 million. We're very interested in driving the innovation and also benefiting from the talent that is here in Ontario. Right? We want to work with the academia, with various other startups, and really bring that all together. There's a lot of other institutes that we work with as well, but we believe that AI can really benefit from all the diversity in all the different locations, and Ontario is a fantastic location here to engage with as well.
And I understand with your company, your focus is the good when it comes to artificial intelligence, because there are people out there wondering, could this eliminate a job?
There's a lot of anxiety around artificial intelligence, but we really refer to it as augmented intelligence, because our focus is really in augmenting the human, making the human much smarter, right? Putting, like what you're wearing right now, better machines, smarter machines, and surrounding the human with smarter machines, right? Making them more productive, making them safer, and making them work on more interesting tasks versus, you know, boring, repetitive stuff. So it's not about replacing humans with robots, it's making humans smarter.
Frank, thank you so much. So the end announcement here today, Nathan and Steph, $125 million that was announced during the federal budget last year by Federal Finance Minister Bill Morneau, and the province also announced $50 million today for this artificial intelligence, this technology that we know is something we will have to keep an eye on. Back to you guys.
All right. Thank you, Courtney. Well, Prime Minister Trudeau also touted Canada's role in the growing artificial intelligence industry during a stop in Brampton today. And he was asked whether the new technology will come at the expense of Canadian jobs.
There is no question that there are going to be challenges with the rapid advances of technology. And the choice we have to take as a country is, do we resist it and try and hide from it, or do we engage in it and look at ways to be able to get more elementary school children learning coding in their schools, get more university students to go towards degrees.